Hello guys. Yes.
Today I will explain you
Meselson and Scales experiment. Okay. That is the part of chapter 6, molecular basis of inheritance. Okay. Matthew Meselson and Franklin Scales performed experiment in 1958 to show that DNA replication is semi-conservative. Okay, to show that DNA replication is semi-conservative. Okay, they experimented with E. coli bacteria. They grew E. coli in a medium containing NH4Cl in which N was N15 type, that is the heavy isotope of nitrogen. This is the heavy isotope of nitrogen. Okay. They grew E. coli in a medium containing NH4Cl in which N was N15 type, which is the heavy isotope of nitrogen. Okay, this E. coli was allowed to grow for several generations in medium containing NH4Cl. As a result, they found that this N15 got incorporated in the nitrogenous bases of the DNA of E. coli bacteria. So both the strands were now N15 type. These both the strands of DNA were now N15 type. This E. coli bacteria containing N15 type was allowed to grow in another medium containing NH4Cl. Okay, NH4Cl here N was N14 type. Okay, this is a normal isotope of nitrogen. This is a normal isotope of nitrogen. N14 is the normal isotope of nitrogen. So, the DNA of E. coli divides in every 20 minutes. Okay, this E. coli bacteria divides in every 20 minutes. So, after every 20 minutes, the nature of the DNA strand, the strands of DNA was observed by Meselson and Scales. Okay, so after every 20 minutes, the nature of the strands of DNA of the E. coli bacteria was observed by Meselson and Scales. The DNA containing N15 nitrogenous base can be easily distinguished from the DNA containing N40 nitrogenous base by a process called centrifugation. Okay, in centrifugation tube, it was found that the DNA which is heavier in nature lies at the bottom of the tube, and the DNA which is lighter in nature lies at the top of the tube. So, between N15 or N14 type DNA, N15 is heavier in nature and settled at the bottom of the tube. This is the N15 type of DNA, and the N14 is lighter in nature and lies at the top of the tube. So this is the N15 that is settled at the bottom of the tube, and this is the N14 type nitrogenous base. Okay, that lies at the top of the tube. After 20 minutes, okay, the DNA which containing N15 type, N15 grow in the medium N14, okay, in this medium it replicate, and after 20 minutes, okay, this DNA is then 15, it replicate in an 14 medium, and after 20 minutes it was found that the two DNA molecule form, okay, which has, one is the old parental strand and one is the newly synthesized strand. Red color strand is a new synthesized strand, okay, and the black color is the old strand. After 20 minutes, the DNA containing N15 isotope, okay, replicate in N14, the medium that containing N14 isotope, okay, and form two DNA molecule. The nature of these two DNA was studied in centrifugation tube, and it is found that it forms the band width at the intermediate region. Okay, it was found that the band was formed in the intermediate region, which means that the two hybrid molecules were formed. Okay, these are the two hybrid molecules were formed. One strand containing N for 15 type and one strand containing N14 isotope. Okay, this is the N15 type, so black color containing N15 type and red color is a new strand, okay, new strand form. This is the containing N14 isotope. So in this way, this is two hybrid molecules were formed. And again after 20 minutes, these DNA molecules was replicated and forms four DNA molecules. Okay, the nature of these strands also was studied in the centrifugation tube, and it was found that two bands were formed. One band was found at the intermediate region. Okay, one band was found at the intermediate region, and second band was formed at the top of the centrifugation tube. Okay, the band that was found in the intermediate region, which means that from four DNA molecules, two DNA was hybrid. Okay, these are hybrid. Okay, these two DNA are hybrid. Okay, containing one strand is the parental strand and one is the newly synthesized strand. Okay, in this way, the second band was formed at the top of the tube, which means that this DNA was light, okay, and containing N14 isotope. This is a hybrid DNA and this is the N14 type. This was a light DNA. So in this way, four molecules, DNA molecules were formed. Two were hybrid and two were light DNA. These light DNA are of N14 isotope. Okay, in this way, we see that after first replication, DNA was neither N15 nor N14. Okay, red color का जो DNA ना, वो क्या show कर रहे हैं? N14 isotope. N14 isotope. After first replication, they saw that after first replication, this DNA was neither
heavy nor light, that means this DNA neither N15 nor N14. Okay, but in between showing the DNA molecule is formed by one all strand N15. This is the all strand N15 and one new strand that contain N14, conforming semi-conservative. Okay, in this way, after secondary application, it was found that two hydride and two light DNA molecule showing semi-conservative. So this experiment proved that DNA replication is semi-conservative. Okay, देखो मतलब इस application में क्या होता है, दोनों strands separate हो जाते हैं. तो ये वाले black color के जो two strands हैं, these strands containing N15 isotope, this separate and red color strand newly formed. This is the new formed strand. This contain N14. So if after first replication, the two hydride molecules are formed. Okay. After the first replication, in second replication, these four hydride strand separated. Okay. ये सारी हो जाएंगे separate हो जाएंगे. Two black वाले और टू क्या हो जाएंगे, रेड. ठीक है, ये चारों स्टैंड्स क्या हो गए, सेपरेट हो गए. और फिर इनके ऊपर क्या होगा, न्यू स्टैंड सिंथेसाइज होंगे. ठीक है, इस तरह से ये न्यू स्टैंड है. अब जो ऑल स्टैंड्स है उनमें से टू के पास तो क्या है, N15 है. टू स्टैंड्स कैसे हैं, N14 वाले हैं. इनके ऊपर क्या है, न्यू स्टैंड्स की फॉर्मेशन होगी. तो वो देखो N14 मीडियम में है तो N14 वाले ही बनेंगे. ठीक है, N14 मीडियम के अंदर मतलब वो ग्रो हो रही है तो वो क्या होंगे, N14 वाले के न्यू स्ट्रैंड्स होंगे. ओके, तो इस तरह से ये न्यू स्ट्रैंड्स बन रहे हैं. अब जो इस आफ्टर सेकंड रेप्लिकेशन फोर मॉलिक्यूल्स बन रहे हैं, उसमें से टू कैसे हैं, हाइब्रिड है, और टू कैसे हैं, लाइट वेट के हैं, दैट कंटेनिंग N14 आइसोटॉप. So in this way, this experiment proved that DNA replication is semi-conservative. मतलब इसमें हमेशा एक स्टैंड उसके पेरेंट को तो ओल्ड स्टैंड होते हैं और एक स्टैंड क्या होते हैं, न्यू फॉर्म्ड होते हैं. So in this way, DNA replication is a semi-conservative. I hope you understand this. Okay, Matthew and Stiles performed experiment in 1958. For this, they experimented with E. coli. They grew these E. coli in a medium containing NH4 Cl, whereas N is N15 tag. This is a heavy isotope of nitrogen. Okay, and after the several generation, the E. coli DNA containing got this N15 got incorporated with the nitrogen in the nitrogenous bases of the DNA of the E. coli bacteria. So these both the strands now N15 type. Okay, this N15 type isotype containing DNA of E. coli then grew in second medium that contain NH4Cl, where N is the N14 type. Okay, after the first replication, okay, they form two hybrid DNA molecule. This showing one is old strand and one is new strand. Okay, these are neither heavy or not light. After the second replication, four DNA molecules are formed that are two hybrid and two light. This experiment show that DNA replication is semi-conservative. I hope you understand this. So watch the video carefully, read chapter from book. Thank you. Have a nice day.